create a function that takes two numbers as arguments and returns an array of multiples of number until the array length reaches length. Okay, so let us say the function name is array of multiples and it will accept two numbers as arguments, num and length. Okay, and it will return an array, right? So let result equal and empty array. Okay, within this portion we will do the calculation. Okay, now let us call this one array of multiples. Let us say the number is 5 and the length is 7 and I will console log the output. Okay, now if I run this, it should give me a blank output, but it is not. Why? Yes, this is a function. Yes. Okay, now it is giving me a blank array. So there are different three different methods I will explain here. The number one is the easiest one for beginner level users. So let us run a for loop. Let I equal 1, I is less than equal length, I plus plus, and here we will push a value to this result array. So result dot push, and what will be the value? The value is number multiplied by I. Okay, now let us run this. So 5 10 15 20, what it is asking, it should return an array of multiples of number until the array length reaches length. Okay, so here it is multiple of this number 5 and the length means number of elements in that array should be 7. Okay, now let us change this, or let us write another example for this. So let us say 2 and this one 12. Now run this. So the first one 7 elements and multiples of 5, second one 12 elements and multiples of 2 2 4 6 8 10 12. Okay, so this is one way of doing this. Let us create another function, array of multiples 1. Here no need to write these things, directly we will return array from here we will pass two parameters. Second one is a function and first one is the length. Okay, now if you pass only this, let us see what happens. So here still we are calling the first function. Let us call this one the second function. Okay, see, now it is returning an array of 7 elements, but all the values of that array are undefined. Okay, now we will define the values. So this second one is just like a map function. In array.map I have already described all those things. If you have not seen this, then please go and watch that one first. Okay, so here The first one is item, second one is index, and it will return number multiply by index plus 1, because index starts from 0. Okay, this for loop we started from 1, right? So it will be index plus 1. Let us run this. See, now we got our result 5 10 15 20 25 30. Okay, so in the first one we used for loop, but in the second one we used array dot from. Let us write another method. Now it is little bit larger, right? Yes, it is clearly visible now. Now let us write another function, and this time this is function 2. Okay, and here we will directly write the length. Okay, then we will use our map. We know map is applied to arrays, so we will use a spread operator here. Now let us clear everything and run this one. See, we are getting the same result. Okay, so I have explained you 3 different methods. You can use any one as per your choice, but all 3 are correct. Okay, thank you.